It is a perfect union between a man and a woman, an acrobatic ballet. Canadians Isabel Brasseur, Lloyd Eisler were next in line for Olympic gold in Norway. But two returning Russian professionals stole their show. Even with the professionals not here, the reigning world champions are in jeopardy of not being able to defend their title. Isabel is in constant pain, a fractured rib. And another Russian pair, Shishkova and Naumov, are poised to seize the opportunity and their crown. Tonight is their last chance to grasp the gold. Brasseur and Eisler go for a second world championship. Tokyo, in a state-of-the-art sports complex where the glitter of skating gold attracts another sellout crowd.
And welcome to the Makuhari Event Center, the continuing coverage of the World Figure Skating Championships here on NBC. And tonight, the pairs title to be decided. And this is an event dominated by the former Soviet Union skaters, the Russians. 9 consecutive Olympics, they've won the gold medal in pairs. And in the World Championship, the last 29 years, only 4 times they have not won the championship. And one of those years, last season in Prague, when the Canadians Brasseur and Eisler were the gold medalists. And joining us now, Kurt Browning knows the feeling. He's won 4 World Championships. Isabel Brasseur, as we have seen, a serious rib injury. You've talked to her. How bad is it?
Well, unfortunately, it's more than a strained muscle. This is a cracked rib. Let me explain to you what that means to Isabel. She's having trouble breathing. She's having trouble turning to talk to you. She's even having trouble sleeping. There's only one position she said she can sleep in, and that's laying on her side, on her right-hand side with the pillows propped up. I gave her a hug, and she flinched. I just am looking up to her. She's so brave to be out there at all.
Okay, how does she even complete the program?
Well, that's a risk as well. She told me that halfway through this program, you might actually see her stop, go over to the board. She said, you know, my amateur career might end 2.5 minutes earlier than it should. I'm nervous even thinking about it.
Marianne Grabovoi has been with the Canadian champions. Let's go down to her at ringside.
Thanks, Dick. Isabel is going to skate with that fractured left rib tonight with the aid of only a small protective pad over it. It looks just like this. It's called a donut. And then she'll have a wrap over that to keep it in place. There was some discussion about trying to inject the area and freeze it, but they decided that was much too dangerous. Even the smallest slip of the needle, and she could have ended up with a collapsed lung. They're going to skate tonight even if they have to stop in the middle of the program. They're not going down without a fight.
All right, Marianne, on the ice, U.S. champions Jenny Mino and Todd Sand. Mino with her coach John Nix, last-minute instructions. They are currently in 6th place after the technical program. Here are the leaders, Shishkova and Naumov from St. Petersburg, the Canadians. Another St. Petersburg couple, Wotzel and Steuer from Germany in 5th place. And talking about injuries, Kurt, Todd Sand told me that after the competition, he'd like to take a month off. The back is killing him.
I've learned that he's even having trouble tying up his own skates. I know how that feels. The confidence level is going way down.
Coach John Nitz told me that this is the most coachable pair he's had since the 79 world champions Ty Babylonia and Randy Gardner. As you know, Todd proposed to Mino during the Olympics, and Nick said maybe it's the romance. They have a sixth sense.
Right off the top if Todd can go for it or not. Split triple twist, their first move. That'll test the back. So 2 revolutions on that twist. They're going for it. They're building up speed for the side-by-side double axle step double toe. There's the effects of a bad back right there. You know, Dick, a sore knee you can push through, but a bad back affects all your skating.
Mm-hmm.
back into this program, it might be right here. It's Road Triple South Count. You know, I really feel bad for this team. I don't think it's their fault. It's so hard to get your concentration back when there's an injury involved.
Was the last American medalist in pairs with Natasha Kuchiki. He won the bronze medal in Munich in 1991.
Oh, I'm not sure what happened there, but I think she got her skate caught in his outfit.
It's happened again. What are the odds on that?
I don't believe this. If it's not one thing, it's another. They really should go over to the referee right now. No, they're free. They're looking over at their coach to see what to do. And they're going to keep skating. I think that might be a mistake. I would have gone over to the referee. Holy cow! Great concentration on Jenny's part. Out of nowhere, beautiful throw double axle.
Oh, wait a minute. Would the referee allow a restart?
Probably not a whole restart, but they might have had that last spin and especially that last spiral sequence over again. Maybe even take advantage of their bad luck. It seems to be all they're having tonight. Says it all.
Jenny Minow and Todd Sand, the U.S. champions. Mistakes, a painful back, falls, bad luck, and some nice moments too. But a difficult way to say goodbye to this competitive year, this attractive pair.
I really hope they don't take that personally, and I hope no one else gets down on them. When you step on the ice as an athlete, it's such a short time out there when things start going wrong and then fate hands you bad luck. You never know. And this is early on the program. That's the first time I think you see for sure that Todd's bad back. That just reminds me of myself 2 years ago. This is the fact that, you know, Jenny's got great throws, and I think tonight she's just worried about her partner. Can't concentrate on her job.
But they're a resilient pair, and while they won't get a medal here in Japan, I am very confident they'll even be able to laugh at their bad luck in this one. Here's their technical merit. Way down into the fours from Germany and Canada.
5-1, 5-1, 5-2. That's
sad. Artistic impression. Five,
and for artistic impression,
five, four, nine,
German judge
five,
unforgiving,
five,
up to the understandably
five,
U.S. being sympathetic. 5-5.
Five, 5-1, 5-3. Thank you.
So a disappointing free performance for the U.S. top team, Mino and San. The top four pairs go for the gold when we...
You kept saying you wanted to end it on a high note. It was a rough night.
Well, I think we've had a great year, so we can't look at this and be disappointed. It was just one of those things that happened, and it's the only time that we've really not skated well since we've been skating together, so...
The decision not to go to the referee and ask for a reskate?
Well... I don't think either one of us knew what to do. My hook was stuck on his pants, and it was kind of a weird situation.
Very awkward
so.
Situation, and we handled it the best we could.
I didn't want to take the chance to go over there, and then if we can't reskate, I didn't really know what to do.
But it's been a great year for you, personally.
Thank you.
Well, personally and professionally, I mean, we've skated well all year, and we didn't have a good competition here, but...
I think it happens to everyone. Everyone has a bad time.
Will you stay in the amateur ranks?
Well, I think we have a lot to look forward to, so we'll take it as it comes.
Better times ahead.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I like the positive attitude of this young pair. Now, here it is from the angle of their coach, John Nix. Someday they may be able to look at this and laugh about it. I bet they will. And John Nix, what's he saying here?
He looks like he's reluctantly saying... Keep going, guys. Push through.
Well, that'll be a moment they'll never forget. Isabel Brasseur, her final thoughts. Coming up, a test not only of her and Lloyd's pair's talent, but a test of her personal courage. For more than a decade, Lloyd Eisler has been pushing baggage through customs, competing at world championships. Isabel Brasseur has been his partner 7 of those years. Finally, they arrive as defending world champions.
Skaters, in this room, please start your goalies.
But Isabel injured her rib before the Olympics and aggravated it soon after she arrived in Japan. Doctors here identified a 2-inch fracture, 8th rib, left side. It hurts to sleep. It hurts to breathe. Yet she's missed only 1 day of practice all week. It should have been more comfortable defending their world title, especially since the other Olympic medalists aren't here. But a severe injury is an undeniable reminder that it won't be easy.
Worse than it did at Olympics. At Olympics, I could feel pain in a few elements, but I knew I could get through it. And this time, you know, I feel pain in cross cut, in spins and jumps, everywhere I felt pain. Even just standing right here breathing, it hurts.
Nevertheless, they answer the call, facing judges and amateur competition for the last time.